I think you talked something about detachment, but not completed.
Yeah, we started. Okay.
Oh yeah.
So yeah. So we have a verse. We're going to begin with a verse from Bhagavad Gita.
我们以《佛家梵歌》中的一个师节来开始。
You all probably know the verse. Arjun said, "The mind is more difficult to control than the wind."
你们大家可能都听说过这个师节，那就是说，我们那个心意呢，比这个控制心意，比控制狂风还要困难。
You know that verse, Lila Rani?
Lila Rani, 有没有记得这个师节？
You should know.
Yes,
you're a psychologist. You should know about that.
应该知道，这是有关这个心理方面的。
So this is what Krishna said. It's Bhagavad Gita chapter 6, text 35.
这是第六章，35世节。
And I'll put it in my own words. Mm. Oh, you want to read it? And well, we have to say it in English also. So,
okay.
Arjuna said, difficult to control the mind. And Krishna said, yes, I know.
Krishna said, yes, I know.
Isn't that funny?
like,
whenever you tell Krishna, he says, I already know that.
无论你跟Krishna说什么，Krishna都会说他已经知道了。Krishna,
I'm a conditioned soul. It's hard to control my mind and senses. Yeah, I know that.
所以呢，就是，you mean Arjuna is a conditioned soul, and
Krishna knows.
就是Krishna知道这个受条件限制的灵魂呢，他其实是没法控制住他的心意的。And
then he says. But it's possible.
然后呢, Krishna又说, 其实要控制住心意还是有可能的。
By practice and detachment.
就是通过这个修习，并且是不依附的去练习。
So today we're talking about detachment.
所以呢，今天我们就来谈一下这个不依附。
So let's start with a very interesting topic, which is detachment from the mind.
让我们来以一个非常有意思的一个话题来开始，那就是说我们需要不依附于我们的心意。Sita Devi,
when your mind says, I want this, do you think that that's you speaking to yourself? And therefore, you go do it?
Sita Devi, 如果你的心意跟你说我想要这个，你认为这就是你自己，就是在跟自己，是你的自我在跟自己说话吗？ 你会就是去做吗？
Let's go back before you were a devotee.
就比如说我们来谈一下，在你成为奉献者之前的，这样的一个情况。
We went to the mall together when I was in China, and then Sita Devi said, before I was a devotee, I used to go to the mall every weekend and go shopping.
就是在我们开会一起有时候去那个购物嘛，然后呢，就是Sita Devi就跟我说，就是在我成为奉献者之前，基本上每周我都会去商场购物。And
so Sita, when you're at the mall, you would see something you like, and then you would think, I like that, I'm going to buy it, right? Correct?
We
all do that.
我们通常都会这么做。
Because whatever the mind says, we think that's us. So when the mind says, I want this, we think that's what I want, because we think the mind is us. Correct?
因为呢，就是无论我们心意想要什么，我们认为就是我们自己想要。 那这样的话呢，我们就认为，嗯，是我的，我需要来满足我的这个愿望。
And so now, it's funny, we're supposed to think, when we're walking in the mall and we think, I want that, we're supposed to stop and then ask, do I really want that? Or is that just my mind saying that I want it? It's a different state of consciousness.
所以呢，就我们去走到这个购物商场，当我们看到自己喜欢的东西的时候呢，我们的心也通常会说，我想要这个。 但是呢，如果我们再深思一下，我真的需要这个吗？那么就是，这就是一种不同的一种知觉状态。Isn't
that interesting? Is that interesting? Isn't that interesting? Jumana Priya, you're supposed to translate what I just said. Isn't that interesting? Or do we lose her? We lost her.
We can go ahead. Good day.
It looks like she just put on headphones instead of using the microphone. Yeah. So, before we're devotees, then we think, whatever I think is what I want. That's me. Whatever the mind says is me talking to. It's me talking to me.
在我们成为奉献者之前，我们的心意告诉我们什么，我们就认为那是我们自己想要的。
Jamuna, what did you do? We can't hear you.
Jamuna, 你还在吗? 我们看不到你。
We can't hear. Nothing.
我们听不到你，你在线吗？
Okay. Okay. So detachment in relation to the mind means that what I think is not necessarily what I want.
所以这种不依附相对于心意来说，就是我们心里想的什么，并不一定真的是我们所需要的。That's a
revolutionary way of thinking, isn't it?
所以这就是我们想象中的一种解脱的方式，我们想心意的一种解脱方式。And
it's to recognize through detachment that I am different from my mind.
所以我们需要去识别我们跟我们的心意是不一样的。So
every time I think I want something, it doesn't mean I want it. It just means, yeah.
所以每次当我想要什么的时候，它并不一定意味着真的是那样。Now
most people think they're the body or the mind. So whatever the body or mind wants, they think they want because they think that's who they are.
很多人都认为我是这个躯体，我是这个心意。所以当这个躯体和心意产生了一种需求的时候，所以我们就会认同于心意和需求的这个需求。So
the detachment for the devotee is that even though the body and the mind say I want something, the devotees separate from the mind and body, and then he can ask, do I really want it? Is this actually good?
所以这个不依附的意思就是说，当心意和这个躯体想要什么的时候，我们跟它保持距离，我们退后看，是不是真的是我想要的，还是这个心意和躯体他们想要的。That's
why Krishna says, you can control the mind by detachment.
所以这就是为什么Krishna说，你可以通过控制你的心意来不依附。Now
we have an interesting
problem.
Yeah, we have an interesting problem.
我们有一个很有趣的问题。Sometimes
when we can't have something, we have it in our mind. We we hold on to it in our mind because we can't have it actually.
就是当有时候我们想要一个什么东西的时候, 我们在头脑里很想要它, 但实际上我们还没有实际的得到它。
So we enjoy it in our mind.
所以我们是在我们的头脑里面进行享乐。
We think about it and then we enjoy it through our thoughts as if we're doing it.
我们心心念念着这个东西, 就好像我们是真的在从事它一样, 这在心意上的一种享乐。
Have you ever done that?
你们曾经都这样做过吗?
Maybe you like think, you think like what it would be like to have $1 million or $100 million or whatever. And you think in your mind like you're enjoying it.
就像有时候我们在心里想, 我有100万, 1000万, 我们在头脑里面这样去过瘾。
Or what it would be like to be famous or beautiful or whatever.
或者想要去有出名, 或者想要变得很美丽, 等等这些。
Or worse, what it would be like to engage in something sinful.
或者更糟糕的就是我们从事于那些罪恶的活动。
And according to Shastra, if you give up something with your body, but you do it in your mind, it has the same effect as if you did it with your body. It has the same effect on your consciousness.
Has the same effect.
Effect on your consciousness, yeah.
就是如果我们想要做什么, 虽然我们的躯体上是没有实际的去行动, 但是我们的头脑里在构思这个事情, 实际上它对我们心意上的这种 反作用是一样的，在经典上说。And
that's why in the Gita, Krishna says a person who restrains himself but meditates on what he's restraining himself from is called a pretender.
所以就是在经典上说，假如说你外在是这个状态， 但是你心里却想着那个东西， 你就是一个伪装者。Isn't
that interesting, Vivian?
这有趣吗, Vivian?
Parker, it's interesting, right?
这个有趣吗, 是吗?
There are 8 levels of brahmachari life.
8th level.
8 stages of brahmachari, or 8 aspects.
就是真守身的8个方面。
So we know brahmachari means no illicit sex.
第一个就是没有这个非法性生活。
But brahmachari means also not to think about it, not to talk about it, not to plan for it, not to lust after a woman. It's all the other, there's more to brahmachari internally than there is externally. There's more to control internally than externally.
就是brahmachari, 就是真守身它是不 不陷入非法性生活，这表示说他不去想着他，他不去心心念念着他，然后并不是说他外在是个真守身，他里面在想着各种各样的其他跟女性的交往。I
want to tell a funny story.
我想告诉你们一个很有趣的故事。
I think Vijayalakshmi, you know about this guy named this so-called sadhu in Bangalore named Nityananda. You know about him?
Yeah.
So I saw some pictures of him when I was flying into Bangalore maybe 2 or 3 years ago.
我在两三年前在班加罗尔的时候看到过这个图片，guru讲的关于这个故事的那个图片。
And when I looked at the pictures, I thought, he's not a sadhu, he's faking it.
就是这个图片上有一个圣人，他看到的时候，他觉得他并不是一个圣人。
And then I looked up a video of him giving a lecture.
然后他guru就去在网上看他的一些视频, 还有他的讲座。
And he was, I'll just say he was very dressed up for a sadhu.
就是 他实际上是外表装打打扮成装扮成的一个圣人。
The turban, the garland, it was planned.
就是大胡子啊，还有花环啊，这些都是他所计划的。
And then his whole lecture was on celibacy.
On
celibacy.
Celibacy
means no.
就是他所有的讲课都是关于解脱吗 ？Celibacy.
遵守。
遵守。你在呀，贾木兰，你在就继续。
你继续嘛。就是我听起来咕噜今天声音有点小，所以我本来想戴着那个耳机那个听得轻一点的，但是好像
你来了就继续
好，你继续吧。我觉得
你继续。
You're okay, Jimena? You're gonna translate?
Yeah, I'm okay, yeah. Just I couldn't hear you very clearly. Sometimes your voice is a little lower, not soloudly. So that's why I want
to make it louder. Is that better?
That's better.
So when I saw him speaking about celibacy, my first thought was he's not celibate and he wants everyone to think he is, so he's speaking about it. He's trying to cheat people. That was my first thought.
Oh.所以李老师你翻译你继续吗就是当Hare Krishna
like for example, let's say I'm a thief and I don't want anybody to know I'm a thief. I give a lecture about how you shouldn't steal.
就比如说其实刚才咕噜说的就是当我第一眼看到他的时候我就知道就是说他其实并没有真正做的真守，但是呢，他却在给人来讲这个真守。他想要人们都认为他其实是已经做到这个真守了，其实他就在欺骗大家，就像一个那个小偷，就像一个人，其实呢，他就是来讲这相关的这个话题，其实他自己本身就根本没有做到，他想让人们认为他并没有偷东西。
Anyway, this so-called sadhu was found later to be having relationships with women.
不管怎么样，就是这个所谓的这个沙杜最后被发现，他真的跟那个女人有染。
But the point is, if it's in your mind, even if you don't do it, if it's in your mind, eventually it's going to come out. You're going to do it.
这个要点就是说尽管你目前还没有做这样的事情但是呢如果你心意里面一直冥想的这个迟早你可能都会这样去做的。
So our goal is that whatever we do, we don't just do it with the body, but we do it with the mind, with the heart, and the body, everything aligned.
所以呢就是我们做某件事情呢就是我们不光是行为上去做，其实还牵涉到，就是说我们的这个心意，然后呢，我们的内心就是完全的，就是说他们应该是协调一致的，就是去做这个事情。
Now the next question you may ask is, but what if I can do it with my body, but I can't do it with my mind?
你可能就会接下来问这么一个问题，那就是如果我的这个，如果我的这个，心，我的这个躯体，可能并没有做这个事情，但是我的心意却想做这个事情呢，
right.
应该怎么办呢
？Like, I don't eat sweets, but I just think about eating sweets all day, but I don't eat any. So what do I do?
就比如说我可能目前并没有吃甜食但是我心里一直在想着我想吃甜食那应该怎么办呢
It's going to go one way or the other. If you don't gradually become detached, then you're going to become attached.
So, Maharaji, can you speak loudly? I couldn't hear very clearly.
This is bad connection, I guess. Yeah. If you don't become attached, you become detached. Okay, I'll put more compression.
Okay.
How's this? Better?
Yeah, better. 就如果我要是不依附的话，那我就会，我如果我不再去依附的话，我就变得这个，就是超脱了。嗯哼。So
the point Krishna is making is detachment is not only with the body, but it's also internally. You have to internally be aligned with the external detachment. That's perfection.
所以呢，这个 Krishna 他就强调的，不光是我们的这个躯体，就是需要保持这种气觉。其实更重要的是内在的我们的这个心意，就是不要去想着这样的事情。那么就是说，我们的躯体行为，我们的这个心意，然后呢，内心，他们都是协调一致的，这才是真正的一个完美的一个气觉。Now
we have a problem.
然后呢，我们现在就有一个问题。We
generally can't become detached just by knowing we should be detached.
就是呢，我们虽然知道我们应该不依附，但是呢，可能我们外在行为上可能还做不到这个不依附。PC,
have you ever eaten something that you know you shouldn't eat?
Maharaji, your voice is very low. I couldn't hear clearly.
I think you need to turn up your speakers.
Yeah.
I have this on louder than I ever normally speak. Can you turn up your headphones? On your...
Maharaji,你能听到姑姑的那个声音吗?我觉得好小啊。
You have on your microphone, you have a volume for your headphones.
没有，我觉得应该是咕噜的声音，咕噜声音太大，所以它变得有点爆音了。所以，应该咕噜还是回到原本的声音。但是，Yamuna的麦克风要再调大声一点点。麦克风跟我的麦克风声音有关吗？
Make your volume, headphone volume louder.
If I may,
very loud.
Already,
there's a buzzing sound from your mic.
Bad internet. I think it's internet. Bad internet problem.
Lilarani, 你听到姑的声音怎么样？如果你觉得可以的话，要不早上你来翻译，然后如果你要是那个听不清的地方，我再给你那个什么一下。 因为我听姑姑的声音真的很小，我不知道什么问题。Lilani,
you have a hard time hearing me?
Good day. I hear your voice is not very clear as before. Not as clear as before. Yeah.
Bad internet problem. I think.
可能是网络的原因。
I think if you were to reduce the volume of the speaker, it might be just over-volumized, and that could be why it's buzzing, because if it was a connection issue, it would cut out instead of buzzing, but that's just my theory. I don't really know.
How do you do in class now?
但是刚才我戴着耳机想听咕噜那个更清晰一点，但是发音有没有声音？
Just wait a second. I have to call my house to tell them to turn off the internet.
大家稍等一下，可能咕噜需要。
Maybe a problem in the house.
他去到另外一个房间。Maybe.
We're having connection problems. Are you on the internet or is Shama on the internet? Okay. All right. Strange. Oh. Maybe that I'm downloading something on my computer. Downloading all the files on the, you know, like 50 gigabytes of files on Logic. Remember? All the samples. I think that's the problem. I think I'm downloading something in the house and it's messing everything up.
Now it sound louder.
It's the internet's just gonna go up and down.
Oh.
Yeah. It's not the microphone, it's nothing, it's the internet is a problem. I'm getting in a couple of weeks I'm getting internet for the office. Now I'm using the house.
Okay.
So we can try. All we can do is try. Okay.
Yeah, I think now your sound is better.
I hear buzzing on your side. Okay, Haribo.
Yeah. Maybe we can continue. Okay. Just try.
We can try. We try.
Okay.
So, I forgot. What was I saying? I forgot.
Detachment does not come.
What's a real detachment?
Oh yeah. You don't. So. You see something, you say, I shouldn't eat it, and you eat it anyway. So detachment, just because you know, doesn't mean you're going to be detached. Hold on one second.
就我们刚谈到了这个，你虽然知道你不应该吃这个东西，但是呢，你还是控制不住自己，你还是会吃，就说呢，我们就有时候知道怎么做，跟我们实际 做的还是不一样的，所以呢，这也是需要我们去就是培养的一种气绝，一个不依附。
So we all know that sometimes we know that we shouldn't do something, and knowing is not enough.
有时候呢，我们就是知道我们不应该去做某件事情，我们仅仅知道还不足够。So
that's why Krishna is saying, you become detached when you experience the pleasure of Krishna consciousness.
所以呢，这就是为什么 Krishna 他说你需要变得气绝不依附，这样的话呢，你才可以去体验到这个 Krishna 知觉的这种喜乐。So,
Prabhupada used to tell us that what you think is pleasure has nothing to do with pleasure. There's no pleasure in it. You don't know what pleasure is.
其实呢，就是Krishna 说我们其实并不
真正的理解真正的快乐是什么？完事，完事，关掉。Yeah.
I closed my video so I can come close to the computer so I can hear you clearly. Is it okay?
Okay. So Prabhupada would tell us your enjoyment is actually suffering.
所以呢，帕巴的告诉我们，其实我们某些时候这个享受呢，其实就是一种痛苦。
And then he would explain, that's because you don't know what spiritual enjoyment is, so you've taken something else as enjoyment.
因为其实你并不了解真正的这个灵性的快乐是什么，你却误以为其他的某些这些享乐
And all of us who met Prabhupada had very, very special experiences with Prabhupada.
我们呢，就是凡是见过圣人帕巴德的呢，就是跟他都有非常这个特殊的之间的这种体验。
Like sometimes we would cry.
就比如说，有时候我们会哭泣。
Or sometimes we would have amazing kirtans, very, very ecstatic kirtans, very special.
有时候呢，我们会有一个非常特殊的这个喜乐的啊，非常这个喜乐的一种 kirtan.
Or sometimes we would experience tremendous happiness in doing something that Prabhupada wanted us to do.
就有时候呢，当我们去做帕巴的想要我们去做的事情的时候呢，我们就会体验的这种巨大的这种快乐。
Or sometimes we would go out to spread Krishna consciousness and we'd feel so much reciprocation from Prabhupada. We just feel like there's nothing better than this.
有时候呢，我们就出去去传播Krishna知觉，我们体验到如此强烈的、如此深刻的这种快乐。我们当时就想，还有什么比这更好的事情呢？
And we would be so happy that as a result, we would become very detached.
所以呢，我们是如此的快乐，所以呢，我们就自然而然的变得就不依附了。So,
although knowledge helps in becoming detached, ultimately, detachment is just a byproduct of advancing in Krishna consciousness.
就是说，虽然这个知识它能够就是帮助我们可以变得这个不依附，但是最终呢，我们需要就是说能够让自己进步到就是可以自然而然的做到这种不依附。So,
detachment happens slowly over years.
所以这个不依附呢，它是一年复一年的逐步的培养起来的，就慢慢的发展起来的。But
I've seen for new devotees, one of the first signs of detachment is they lose a lot of interest in the things they used to do.
对于新的奉献的来说呢，就是在他们身上的这种不依附呢，就体现在他们就是失去了对于过往他们
Yeah, so that's a sign of detachment. You're beginning to lose interest in material things.
所以呢，这就是不依附的一个征兆，就是说你已经失去了原来你对于那些物质事物的一种兴趣。You're
not finding pleasure in things that you used to find pleasure in.
就是那些过往你是以此而取乐的事情，你现在不再感受到快乐了。That's
a sign you're making advancement.
所以这就是你取得进步的一种标志。And
another sign is you're becoming attached to serving, to chanting, to hearing.
另一方面呢，你却依附于 就是喜欢了这个唱诵，喜欢去服务。So
one lecture, Prabhupada said, by your detachment, you can calculate, you can evaluate how you're advancing in your spiritual life.
就是曾经在一次讲课当中呢，圣人帕帕的就说，就是通过你的这个 不依附的这种程度，你就可以来衡量你在Krishna知觉中到底取得了多大的进步。And
so, by the opposite is also true. If we're becoming more materially attached, That means there's a problem in our spiritual life. Something's wrong.
所以呢，相反的情况呢，也是一样的。 那么，如果你是越来越依附于你的物质的生活的话呢，那么就说明你的灵性生活是存在的某些问题的，你肯定是走错了方向。How
can we say that?
我们怎么能这样说呢？
Because Krishna is better than everything in this world, and if we're becoming attached to Krishna, then nothing looks as good as it used to look.
因为 Krishna 是这个世界上最棒的。如果我们依附于 Krishna 的话呢，就那些过去我们看起来是非常美好的事物，就变得不是那么的有趣。
So that's a way you can calculate, one way you can calculate your spiritual advancement.
所以呢，这就是一种方式，你可以去估算你在灵性生活中的你的这个进步程度。So
we have a question.
现在有一个问题吗？ Wow. Yeah.
I have a question.
Okay.
Could you let, this might sound silly, so if it does, excuse me, please. But
Where are you? Who's asking?
Oh, Billy.
All right. Why don't you put your video on?
I'm embarrassed.
Where are you?
I'm in my living room.
What city?
Oh, Agawam. Massachusetts.
Oh, okay.
I guess I'm curious, like, examples of what material world things would be. That might sound silly, but I...
Yeah, okay, that's a good question, though. I can...
Thank you.
Like, she's asking, what would be examples of material things we would be attached to?
Example?
She wants to know what would be an example of the material attachment.
Okay. 她的问题呢，她就想问一下这个物质的依附，这个表现是什么？能不能举一下例子？
So we have to understand a few basic things to answer that question.
就是呢，要回答这个问题的话呢，我们需要理解一些基本的一些要点。When
we define material, we mean that I'm looking at this world in relation to how I can enjoy it.
就是当我们说这个物质的时候呢，那就意味着就是呢。 我看待这个世界是以我怎么能够在这个世界上享受这个为这个视角的。
And the way we define spiritual is that I look at the world in relation to how I can use that, how it can be used in service to Krishna, service to God, and then in service to everyone.
所以呢，当我们说灵性的时候呢，那就意味着我就是看待这个世界，我如何能够利用这些能够去服务 Krishna， 服务神，服务每一个人。So
let's say Billy Lin, you like to do something. Well, let's say you like to sing. We'll just say you like to sing.
就比如说这个你喜欢那个唱歌。So
you could sing to get people to like you and think, oh, you have a beautiful voice, you're a beautiful singer. And so you go on stage and sing and think, oh, everyone's going to like me. It's going to make me feel good.
你可能唱歌呢，你就是。 能够为了就是吸引到别人，让别人喜欢上你。那么你可能在舞台上唱歌的时候呢，你就会就是当别人跟你说， 哎呀，你看他的歌声多么美妙呀！他是这么啊、就是优秀的一位歌手。那么当人们这样说的时候呢，你就感觉自我良好。
So then basically you'd be singing just to please your ego, or just because you, or maybe not please your ego. You might be humble, but just because you like to sing, it makes you feel good.
嗯，就是说，其实你的这种唱歌呢，大多数情况下都是想要满足自己的这种自我，所以呢，你就是想唱歌让自己感到这种自我良好。
If you ask someone, why are you doing that? It sounds like a stupid question. So of course I'm doing it because I like it. What do you think? Why else would I do it? Makes me feel good.
有些人如果是要是问你这个问题，你为什么要这么做呢？你就觉得这是一个愚蠢的问题，因为很自然的，我之所以就是唱歌，因为我喜欢，我想让我自己感觉很好。
But if you ask a devotee why you're doing that, he'll say, I'm doing this to give Krishna pleasure or to serve my spiritual master, or I'm doing this because it'll help other people become Krishna conscious. It's nothing to do about him feeling good or his ego getting boosted. It's just about service.
但是呢，如果你要是问奉献者这个问题，你为什么会这样做呢？那么这个奉献者呢，他可能就会回答说，他想要给 Krishna 带来快乐，或者他想要去取悦他的灵性导师，或者是呢，他想要给予其他人这个 Krishna 知觉，他们就完全没有考虑到去想要满足自己的这种自我，他们考虑的就是去服务。
So the more you think about how you can use your abilities, intelligence, resources in service to Krishna, to Krishna's devotees, and in helping other people become Krishna conscious, that's the sign of detachment.
所以呢，不管你有什么样的这个才能、资源，如果你考虑的就是说用这些去如何更好的服务于 Krishna 以及他的奉献者们，以及就是让其他人变得具有 Krishna 知觉，那么其实这就是你的一个不依附的一个体现。
One second.
稍等一下。
Okay, so we'll give a visual demonstration.
给你们做一下演示。
Visual. Two circles. Can you see them?
Yeah, yeah. 就咕噜画了两个圆圈，
yes.
能看到吧？
Okay. One circle represents the material world.
一个圈呢就代表着物质世界。
Okay. The top one represents the material world, the bottom the spiritual world. Okay?
就是上面的代表着物质世界，下面的代表着灵性世界。
So, here's the question.
所以下面的问题就是
If you're in material consciousness, who is in the center of that circle?
Maya.
如果你要是处在这个物质的知觉当中，你是处在哪一个圈里？
Okay, I'll ask a second.
Oh, sorry.
No, go ahead.
I would say in the middle of the material world circle, it would be service to Maya.
Yeah. And who's in the middle of the spiritual circle?
It would be Lord God Krishna and Srimati Radharani.
Yeah, and so basically, you and Maya would be in the first one, and Krishna would be in the second one, and you'd be outside serving, giving things for him. And in the first one, you and Maya would be working together to get as much as you can.
就是我们就是如果是服务自己的话呢，我们就是是跟玛雅待在一起，我们就处在这个第一个圈子里面，就是第二个圈子里面它的这个核心呢应该是 Radha Krishna。 就是呢我们就是如果想要去服务他们的话呢，我们就在这个灵性的这个圈子里面。
So whenever you're thinking about how you can serve in a million different ways you can serve, then you're in the spiritual world. And whenever you're thinking about, you know, how you can enjoy this world independent of Krishna, then you're in the material world.
就是任何时候如果你去想如何去服务，其实这个服务的方式可以有成千上百万种。那么这个时候呢，你就是你处在这个灵性的世界，你就考虑的是如何去服务 Krishna。当你想着就是如何能够在这个物质世界的里面享受的话，其实你就处在这个物质世界当中。
Sometimes I ask a funny question.
有时候呢，我会问一个非常有意思的问题。
If tonight I transferred $1 million into every one of your bank accounts, what would you do with it?
就比如说，如果今天晚上我往你们的银行账户每个人都给你们存上上百万的美金，你们会拿这笔钱做什么？
Be honest.
你们一定要诚实哦。
You say, I'll give the money to Mayapur after I buy a mansion and a Mercedes Benz and, you know, so many things. Yeah. So,
I give this donation to Mayapur after what?
After I buy a mansion and a Mercedes Benz and a new iMac and a new this and that.
就是说在我在我有自己的这个很多的计划实现之后，就比如说去那个大学呀，还有其他的一些规划之后，我会把这个剩下的就是做一些捐赠给玛雅普。
So the answer to this question kind of gives us an idea of how we can check in where our consciousness is.
所以呢，根据你对这个问题的回答，就可以就是衡量出你到底处在什么样的一种知觉状态。
Because if we're more detached, I could say this for sure, if we're more detached, we can use that $1 million in so many wonderful ways. And even though we wouldn't use any of it for our own sense gratification, that $1 million spent in Krishna service would make us much happier than that $1 million spent in our sense gratification. That's for sure.
这是毫无疑问的，就是说如果我们是处在一种不依附的一种知觉状态的话呢，那么我们花这笔钱的话呢，我们就会考虑如何是为 Krishna 做更好的服务。那么我们从中得到的这种快乐呢，也要比就是我们花这笔钱仅仅使我们自己快乐，满足自己的这个欲望要快乐的多。
There was a group of brahmacharis in 1975, 1974, 1975.
在大概就是1974年、1975年的时候呢，就是有一位brahmachari。
Brahmachari is a group.Traveling in Japan. They were in Japan raising money for Vrindavan Temple.
就是呢，他们是在这个日本有一群这个 Brahmachari 的一个群体，他们呢就是在那个 Vrindavan 建庙之前，他们都开始筹集资金。
They worked like 12, 13 hours a day, raising donations from people on the street of Japan. 7 days a week for months.
他们呢一连数几个月，他们呢就是就是去每天 大概工作12-13个小时，他们去到街上，然后呢，去给人们就是募捐，向人们募捐。
And they would come back and meet Prabhupada in Vrindavan and put a briefcase on his desk with $100,000 in, actually $108,000, and leave it on his desk.
How much dollars?
$108,000.
$108,000. 就他们去到文达问的时候，他们把这笔钱就放到帕帕德的面前。
1975, 108,000.
是吧，对。
Maybe worth $500,000 now. Maybe more than $500,000.
或许比这个数额还要多。
And they take that money and they give it to Prabhupada.And that was the greatest happiness of their life, to give all that money to Prabhupada.
当他们把这笔钱给帕帕德的时候呢，他们就感受到这种巨大的一种喜乐，这是他们的一个快乐的一个来源。
So, you can enjoy infinitely more by giving to Krishna than you can by trying to get for yourself. That's for sure.
所以呢，我们就是可以体现到更多的这种无限的这种快乐。当我们去给予 Krishna， 而不是，只是给予我们自己的时候。
Definitely。
这一点是确定无疑的。
So now, Billy Lin, I have something else to say. It's very interesting.
现在呢，我来说一些非常有意思的一个事情。Yeah.
Prabhupada sometimes uses the word conditioned soul.
Prabhupada 呢，他就是有时候非常，就是worried.
Conditioned.
就是呢 ，Prabhupada 他就非常的就是，为这个受条件限制的灵魂而担忧。
It means we're habituated to thinking about how we can enjoy.
他呢其实就是他不知道 you mean he didn't so can you repeat the second sentence?
Leo Rani, in psychology they use this word conditioning to mean how all the influences that affect you, that make you who you are, your habitsYour attitudes, it's called conditioning. It's like, you understand the word conditioning? What it means?
Yeah, I know, yeah. 就说那个, yeah. I just want to check what you exactly say. 所以呢，就是说帕帕德他就把这个受条件限制的灵魂，就是说他们的这个受条件限制的这个状况呢，就是包括他们的这个习惯呀，他们做事情的这个方式啊等等，会体现在不同的这个方面。
So, in the beginning of the Gita, Krishna is saying, "Just do everything for me."
在薄伽梵歌的开始呢 ，Krishna 就说。你只是去为我做所有的这一切。
Yad Kuroshi, Yad Ashnashi, Yad Jahoshi, Dadasi, Yad Tapasyasi Kanteya, Tad Kurusha Marabhanam. Yad Kuroshi, whatever you do, Yad Tapasyi, whatever austerity you perform, Yad Kuroshi, whatever you give away, whatever you, you know, just do it all for me.
所以呢，就是。Krishna 他就说，无论你做什么，无论你就是供奉什么，无论你做什么的苦行，
Why is he saying that?
他为什么要这么说呢?
Well, in one sense, he's saying, stop thinking about yourself. It doesn't work.
所以呢，他其实就是一方面，他在向我们提示，就是。 不要再继续想你自己了，你这并没有，就是这并不会起到什么的作用的。Now,
Billy Lynn, what's really interesting is after Krishna says this, he says something else, which I find interesting.
在Krishna讲完这些之后呢，他说了另外的非常有意思的事情。
He says, even if you can't do it for me, do it for somebody other than yourself. Serve somebody.
Krishna说，就是即便你目前还达不到这个层面，就是说直接为我服务，就是那么你可以至少可以去服务其他人，而不是去服务你自己。这样的话会逐步的提升你的。
In other words, he's saying, start practicing serving others because for lifetimes you've been serving yourself and that's what's causing you to remain in this world life after life.
所以呢，就是换句话说，Krishna就是提倡你要去服务于他人，因为呢，一世复一世的你都在服务于你自己，这就是为什么你现在还束缚在这个物质世界中受苦。
So when you're thinking about serving Prabhupada, serving Krishna, serving other people, more than you're thinking about yourself, then you're advancing.
所以呢，当你去考虑服务圣人帕巴德，服务 Krishna, 服务其他人的时候呢，你其实就已经在进步了。
And when you're thinking about yourself, you're thinking, well, these are things I need for myself so that I can do my service better.
就是当你真的是为自己考虑的时候呢，你也可以这样想，就是呢，这些是我就是说基本的一些需求，因为我这些需求满足之后呢，我就可以更好的去服务于其他人。You
know, just like if you're tired, you can't function. You have to get a certain amount of sleep. So we need a certain amount of things in this world so that we can be satisfied and happy so that then we can give ourselves completely to the service of others.
所以就比如说你那个非常疲惫的时候呢，你其实就需要稍作休息。同样的就是说，因为我们在这个物质世界，我们是需要一些基本的一些需求。那么当这些基本的需求 我们满足之后，我们内在呢，就是感到这种满足快乐之后呢，我们就可以把自己完全的去给予别人，完全的去服务于别人。Is
that okay?
啊，可以吗？
That answered your question.
I'll tell you that it answers it much better than I anticipated it would, and I'm very grateful to you.
Good. Yeah, because you have to explain everything to answer it properly.
以这种方式来回答他的问题，比他想象的要，就是回答的多得多。
Billy Lynn, I'm not famous for short answers. Go ahead.
I was nervous that I would have to ask follow-up questions, and then I was worried about what would happen after that, and then having it all just answered was very relief. Thank you.
Okay. You're welcome. You can relax now.
本来他也担心他这个问题，但是呢，现在就是Guru给到他一个非常美妙的一个回答。It's good to ask
questions.
提问的话呢，是非常好的。And
sometimes Prabhupada would say, if you don't understand, then ask. Just keep asking until you understand.
有时候呢，爸爸的就会说， 如果你真的不懂还不理解的话呢，那么你就需要不断的问问题，直到你弄懂为止。
I'll explain why Prabhupada said that.
我来给你们解释一下帕巴达为什么会这样说。
Because it's like, let's say, Billy Lynn, you ask me, how do I get to Boston from where you live? And I explain it, and then I say, you understand, because I want to make sure you don't get lost. So I ask you, if you don't understand, just ask again. I'll explain it again. So Prabhupada wanted to make sure we don't get lost on our way back to Godhead. So ask questions. If you don't understand, ask again. So you know the next step, the next step, the next step.
就比如说你问我怎么去到这个波士顿，那么我就跟你讲，那么如果你要是不理解的话呢，你就需要不断的问，以确保就是我要确保你不会弄丢了。同样的道理就是呢，帕巴的就给我们说，因为我们现在是走在回归守神的这个路上，如果你要是不懂的话呢，你一定要不断的问，直到你弄清楚。否则的话，你就容易给那个走丢。
So, the spiritual master is giving instructions how to get from the material world to the spiritual world, and he wants to make sure you understand. Otherwise, you'll take a wrong turn and get lost and have to come back again, take another body.
所以呢，就是灵音导师给到我们这个讯息呢。可以让我们从灵性世界，从那个物质世界，就是去回到这个灵性世界。那么，如果我们就是不理解他的这个教导，还没弄明白他到底给我们的这个讯息的话呢，那么我们就需要不断的去问，直到自己弄懂。否则的话呢，你会就是花很长的时间，而且容易走偏、弄丢。所以呢，你要是不懂的话呢，你可能就会再一次会投生，还会一直留在这个物质世界。
In the end of the Gita, Krishna told Arjuna, "If you don't understand, I'll explain everything over again."
包括在这个《薄伽梵歌》中 ，Krishna 他对阿尔朱那也说。如果你还没有理解我所教导给你的这些的话呢，你就需要不断的来问，直到就是你彻底的弄懂为止。
So Prabhupada's definitely giving us the roadmap back to Godhead, and he just wants to make sure we understand how to go, because it's very, very important that we understand.
所以呢，帕巴的已经给了我们如何去回归守神的这么一个。地图，然后呢，他要确保我们一定要理解，这样的话呢，我们才可能回到我们的这个家园，否则的话呢，就是我们可能就会迷失了方向。所以这一点就是我们要理解他的这些教导，其实是非常重要的。
Okay, we have another question.
还有另外一个问题。
Parker
bro. Okay, I read the question in Chinese. Okay.
Let me read it first in English.
Okay. Guru 先用英文读一下这个问题。
I think it takes a good while longer to realize the reality of Krishna consciousness and Prabhupada when we haven't seen Prabhupada in the flesh.Even when I experience the bliss of Krishna consciousness, it's a constant effort to remind myself of the progress, almost like I don't believe what I experience is real. Some months are very detached and others it doesn't come so easily. How can we determine how detached we are when it changes from time to time?
就是他这个问题呢，就是说，我们要真正的就是觉悟到这个 Krishna 知觉的这么一个现实，还是要花很长的时间的。 去觉悟到这个 Krishna 知觉以及圣人帕帕德，因为我们并没有亲自的就是在现实生活中见到过这个圣人帕帕德。即便就是当我真的是体验到了这个 Krishna 知觉的快乐的时候呢，我还是需要不断的提醒我自己，我的这种进步，就好像我并不真的相信我所体验到的这些就是真实的，因为有时候呢，有些那个月份的时候呢，我会非常的这个不依附，但是呢，有些时候呢，我要变得这个不依附呢，并不是那么容易，所以呢。就是我怎么能够就是随着这个时间的不断的这个变化，那么我可以一直做到这种不依附。
Well, based on your question, the answer is that your detachment will be in how well you follow the practices even when you don't feel like following them.That will be your detachment.
就是呢，你的这个不依附呢，应该体现在就是你如何去追随我们的这个程序，即便有时候你本人可能并不愿意去这样去做。
The other thing I would say is that the many, many devotees met Prabhupada, and they're not.Doing well right now.
而且呢，我还想说的另外一点呢，就是即便当时那些已经见过圣帕巴的那些人呢，他目前灵修状况就是目前做的并不是很好。
And others have only met Prabhupada through his books and his service and through their spiritual master, and they're doing better in some cases than those who met Prabhupada.
而另外一种情况呢，那些即便没有亲自见到过圣人帕帕德，但是呢，他们通过灵性导师的这个训示，通过服务灵性导师，通过呢，就是去执行灵性导师的这个训示，那么他们通过做各种各样的服务，他们目前的一个状态要比那些甚至亲自见过帕帕德的灵修状况还要好得多。
Having not met Prabhupada is not an obstacle.
所以呢，就是没有见到过圣人帕帕的，这并不是一种障碍。
But I can tell you what the obstacle is.
但是呢，我可以告诉你真正的这个障碍会是什么。
Thinking that I haven't met Prabhupada is an obstacle is the obstacle.Did you understand, Jamuna?
It's broken, so I didn't hear a sentence.
If I think that because I haven't met Prabhupada, that's a bit of an obstacle for my spiritual life, that thinking is actually the obstacle. The fact that you haven't met Prabhupada is not really the obstacle, but the obstacle is thinking that I haven't met him is an obstacle.
Yeah.就是我们没有亲自见到过圣人帕帕的这一事实并不能成为我们灵性进步的一种障碍，而就是说我认为我没有见到过帕帕的，他会阻碍我的灵性生活，那么这种想法它其实就是一种障碍。
So the answer is no matter how you feel, your detachment will be evaluated in your steadiness, that you don't feelSo Krishna conscious, but you're steady in your service. You keep going.
就是呢，
that's your detachment.
你的这个不依附的这种体现呢，可以体现在就是说你在 Krishna 知觉中的一个稳定的一个程度，就是即便有时候你可能没有感受的来自于修习 Krishna 知觉的这种快乐，但是呢，你仍然就是在 Krishna 知觉中做的这个服务。就是这一点本身就是体现了你的这种不依附。
Correct?
Sure, yeah.
Sure, sure.
Can I speak? Is that allowed here?
If you speak briefly, because she has to translate, so.
My question was more referring to little things, nuances.
Such as?
Overeating, mundane conversations, just kind of wasting time with the guys, things that are not so overtly harmful, but just definitely aren't helpful for bhakti.
And your question is, what to do about it?
Yeah, it's difficult sometimes to have the motivation to renounce these things on behalf of bhakti when they're not so overtly detrimental. Like regulative principles, it's like, duh, don't do that.
Okay. More subtle. You understand the question, Jumana?
Hare Krishna, yeah. His voice is broken. Yeah, only heard some words. Yeah. So can you repeat your question?
He was saying sometimes he eats too much. Sometimes he wastes time talking to the other devotees. What else do you do?
Just a general lack of urgency.
Yeah, being a little lazy. And the question is what to do about it?
Yeah, and the point about Prabhupada was the motivation factor.
Yeah, be more motivated. He's amazing. Thinking if he met Prabhupada, he'd be more motivated. Yeah. Right?
Krishna之觉的时候呢, 自己可能浪费了很多的时间，有时候又非常的懒惰，可能有时候呢还会就是挑别人的这个错，等等。那么就是他如何能够就是说，就是为了这个修习这个Krishna知觉的，为了这个奉爱的这个益处，就说能够让自己变得就是不依附，他应该怎么办？
It's the basically the same answer, but I could add one thing.
基本上跟前面的这个回答有些类似，但是呢，我在这里再补充一点。
There's a saying, anything that's worth doing is worth doing well.
有一句谚语就是说，如果你觉得这个 事情值得去做的话呢，那么你就会把它做得很好。So
we have to look at Krishna consciousness like, I'm already doing it. So why should I waste time not doing it well?
我们需要以这种方式去看待 Krishna 知觉，因为 Krishna 知觉是如此有价值的一件事情，我们已经在修习 Krishna 知觉了，那么 我们为什么不能把它做好呢?
It's like life is good and I'm making progress. So, you know, why be so intense about it?
Why worry?
It's like a little bit more abstract for us than when you have Prabhupada here and you have, you know, the urgency that he brought, it just seems like it was much more real. And now it's knowledge that the onus is on the practitioner nowadays.
Jumana, he's saying that when Prabhupada was here, Prabhupada had a mission and we were all just completely dedicated to his mission. But coming 50 years after Prabhupada, we don't feel the same urgency that the disciples of Prabhupada felt.
就是说他的接下来又提的这个问题呢，就是说当圣帕巴德他在世的时候呢，就是当时的那些奉献者们，他们呢都感受到一种强烈的一种使命感，但是呢，当比如说50年过去之后呢，我们现在就感受不到像帕巴的门徒那种强烈的使命感，那么我们应该怎么办？
Yeah, I would say you need to listen to Prabhupada more. More lectures, more morning walks, more conversations, read his books more. You'll feel the same way we felt.
你们就去聆听帕帕的这个讲课，去阅读他的书籍，去就是阅读他的这个跟奉献者之间的这种谈话交流。
Okay. Try it. I guarantee it works. One morning walk every day, one chapter of Bhagavatam, that'll knock the maya. That'll knock the maya out of you.
然后呢，你每天就是读一折帕巴的这个清晨散步的谈话，读一章就是圣典薄伽瓦坛，那么这样的话呢，就不会让你陷入这个玛雅当中，一直不断的尝试知道它那个就是对你产生作用。
You know, it's either a morning walk or a lecture or conversation. Because you can hear, when you hear the urgency in Prabhupada's voice, and sometimes when we were in a class, when Prabhupada would speak, It was like a thunderbolt hit the class and all the devotees were shaking. You're not the body. Just the way he said it, you know, would knock the maya out of you.
Sorry.
Did you understand?
Sorry. Your voice is broken. Lilarani, 你听呼的声音怎么样呀? 反正这一会儿好像断续的还挺严重的。 你那里听起来呢？啊，还好，跟之前一样，连续的。啊，因为我今天呢，我这边就是我是用的那个我的手机的那个流量今天连的，所以好像我这边信号稍微有一点不是那么好，要不那个接下来你先翻译一下，我稍微离开一下，然后刚好因为这会儿我这边信号。 就听起来不的说话是断断续续的，应该行不行？那你把这个翻译了，我就接着来翻译，好吗？OK，行，我把这个问题翻译完。然后你跟咕噜说一下你的情况哈。OK。
Prabhupada will.
Can you repeat? Because.
What you said, your voice is broken.
I didn't hear it clearly.
So I think maybe
after this question, I will ask Lilarani to translate.
Okay. Prabhupada's words were...
She said she can hear you clearly.
Okay, Lilarani,
okay.
You can translate? Yeah.
Uh-huh. Okay, I translate.
Prabhupada's words can shake you up. Sometimes you see in the movies, the tough guy grabs your shirt and it's like,
make the wrong move. 就像一个人他拽着你的这个衣，然后用非常严厉的姿态指着你。嗯，庞帕德的话语就像这样的力量，非常的震撼我们。
If you need more shaking, more inspiration, just listen more.
我们需要的就是这样的一种震撼，这样的激励。我们再也不需要更多的。Okay,
we have the next question. If you go to the chat, you can see the next one.
Okay, 好，我们来到下一个问题。下，the next question is from Lily Ping. She said, I live for material life. I will start to work hard, but now I don't want to do this way. I want to observe. I know I need to observe my material life well, but I feel boring. I hate to do. How to balance? Thank you, mm-hmm. dear Gurudev. Thank you. Thank you, translator.
Keep your life simple and do what you have to do, and the rest of the time do devotional service.
就是让你的生活变得简单，做你应该做的，那剩下的精力就用来做服务就好了。You
know, and always remember that you made a choice to come to this world, and this is the price we have to pay, but it's also purifying.
就是我们降临到这个地球上，实际上是我们自己的选择。那么我们必须要为此而付出代价，所以我们要净化自己。
If you just want Krishna, then go back to the spiritual world. You don't have to work there.
如果你只是想着 Krishna, 那你就会回归到灵性世界，你就不用在这儿工作了。
You can pray, Krishna, someday I just want to work for you, nobody else.
你可以祈祷说, Krishna, 我只想为你服务，我不想为其他人服务，让我回到你身边吧。
Okay. I think it's always good to use the bad to become an impetus to be more Krishna conscious.
有时候其实把我们这些不想要的东西变成一种动力，转换成。 转换成想要的，它其实是一种动力。这种不想，这种坏的东西，它可以转换成一种动力。Okay,
next question.
Next question. Next comment, not question. Mew said, "This you talked about the story about Srila Papa said we are lost on the way to Godhead." This story is very moving, is very moved.
Good, yeah.
And the next question is from Mew also. The question is, not attached the material sense gratification is also include take care of our health of our body. Thank you, Gurudev.
Yeah, no, you have to take care of your health and body.
是的，你必须要照顾好你的身体。
But then it also depends why are you taking care of your health and body, so you can enjoy or so you can serve. So it all depends on why you're doing something.
所以这个原因是来自于说，你照顾好你的躯体是用来你的自己的感官享乐呢，还是用来你服务 Krishna？所以你照顾好你躯体的这个动机很重要。Yeah.
I have lots of vitamins I take every day.
我每天我都会做很多的锻炼。And
every day I walk.
每天我要散步，照顾我的身体。
And eat healthy.
就是 eat healthy. 健康的吃.
Yeah. Well, why do I do that?
那为什么我要做这一切呢?
So I can enjoy my body? No, so my body can be healthy so I can serve.
是因为我为了享受我的躯体吗? 不是的. 是因为如果我照料好我的躯体, 我才可以更好地服务。
So, Miu, take care of yourself.
So, Miu, 好好照顾你自己.
For Krishna.
为了 Krishna.
Krishna, Hare Krishna. Anything
Hare
Krishna.
Else? No more question.
Good.
So.
We can end class now. I have your permission.
Guru,
I have one more question if I'm allowed to do two at once. Not now, because I've already done one earlier, but okay. If I do a second one.
You know the joke? You know the joke? The aspiring disciples goes to the guru. He finds him on the top of the Himalayas, and the guru says, "You have three questions." And the aspiring disciple says, "Why only three?" And he says, "You have two left." And then he says, "Only two?" And he says, "You have one left."
就是guru刚才在问说，还有没有？
That's a joke. You understand?
I was laughing. But I didn't want to speak over the translator.
Okay, anyway, we just told a joke. She has one question left. Okay, you can ask.
So,
okay, you please, Mataji.
Thank you. So talking about health, taking care of the physical body in order to serve Krishna.
Yes.
I hope this isn't rude to wish for this in a chat room like this, but I'm wishing for a guru and I'm still looking.
Yes.
And obviously you have to take time to get to know the person, but
I've
been nervous about finding a guru because I have an energy body that it's very sensitive. So I can feel harmful energy or helpful energy in my body when I enter a space. So it takes a lot of maintenance. And I've had devotees say to me, "Why are you so selfish?" Because I have to cleanse a lot. I have a lot of tools that I use to keep my body from getting weird stuff in it. Because the minute it comes in, I have to get it out in some way, or it might affect what I intuit. So I want to find a guru.
Let her translate first. That's a lot. Do you understand, Lita Rani?
I want to clarify. Guru Maharaj, you can talk to me again.
Yeah, she's saying she's looking for a guru, but she's very sensitive to negative energies.
就是这个马太吉说，他是在寻找一位guru，但是呢，他是对那个负性的那个能量是非常敏感。
And if she gets around negative energy, she has to cleanse herself of that.
如果他得到了那种负性的能量的话，他会整个身体他是非常的紧绷。
And then the devotees were telling you what? That sense gratification, or why are you so sensitive? Or what
I had not all of the devotees, but I've avoided talking to devotees because of it.
Negative devotees.
Well, they were saying, "You're selfish. Why are you doing all this? It's selfish."
Oh, okay.
And that was what the wording was, what one or two of them used.
Okay.
Guru问到这个马太吉说，你有没有问过其他的奉献者，为什么你接受到负性能量，你会变得这么的敏感？然后，对，然后就Guru就刚才是问到了这样一个问题。 然后马太吉的回答是，他说他是询问过一些奉献者。Guru又问，你是询问的那种负性能量的奉献者吗？马太吉说不是的。Okay,
you can go ahead.
Thank you very much. With the cleansing, I absorb good energy too, so I have to make certain that I keep up on it. But trying to find a guru while being anxious, is the guru that I eventually commit to going to say, this is not right? I'm sure there might be some perfecting of the different techniques that I use. For example, the Maha Mantra definitely helps a lot, but some days I feel so fatigued because I feel prana has left me and I have to pull it in again. And I'll pause because I don't want to.
Well, let me kind of rephrase it, because I can answer it and I can give part of the answer in the question you're asking. There's a concern about having a guru who you might have to defend yourself from. Is that what you're saying?
I understand that there's a lot of people who just have not had this happen to their bodies. Having spiritual in the physical body is unusual for most people. So they don't understand it and they have different reactions.
Yeah. Yeah. And there's a question or a statement? Or you want me to comment? Or
I'm wishing for a guru, and I'm searching, and I found you, and I don't know you very well, but getting to know you would be helpful in determining whether I should work with you, or if I would even be received by somebody. I shouldn't even assume that.
Yeah. All right. Let me rephrase this so everybody can understand the conversation. I'll just rephrase it in a general way, because I think there's a philosophical point here. The personal point, you know, because this is a group, so we could talk personally another time. That, yes, you have to get to know a guru. Yes, that's true.
Good day, need I translate? Or you just personally?
Yeah, just translate me. And you also have to explain to the guru what you just explained to me.
就像你去找一个guru，就像你刚才跟我说话。
Now there's a problem.
有另外一个问题。
The guru has to correct you if you do something wrong.
因为guru他会指责你，会指出你的错误。
And that could be perceived as negative when it's not, it's positive.
所以就是当guru指出你的错误的时候呢，有可能你会把它视作是一种负性的东西。 但是如果你从另一个角度来看的话，你就不会这么理解。But
it goes deeper because the relationship between the guru and disciple is not something so analytical, but it's very affectionate relationship.
其实guru和门徒的关系它并不是那么分析性的，它是一种 人与人之间感情的一种关系和交流。
So there should be natural affection there. And if there's natural affection,
所以它是一种很自然的感情流露在那里，那份关系当中。
Everything goes well.
一切都进展得很好。
Nothing to protect yourself from, unless you don't like love, unless you get too much love.
其实你并不需要去回避什么或者保护什么，其实一切都是为了你好。所以。
But Prabhupada said something interesting about this. You know, normally we think of the guru as one who gives love and the disciple reciprocates.
Pardon? Good day.
Normally we think the guru gives love and the disciple returns the love.
通常我们会想，guru他是给予爱，然后门徒会回赠予爱。
And Prabhupada once said, if you love me, I will love you. He turned the whole thing around. So when you look for a guru, you're looking for what the guru can do for you, but you should be looking more, what can I do for the guru?
所以你在寻找一位guru，你在想guru能给予我什么？实际上，你应该反过来想，你要想我可以为guru做什么。And
we saw that with Prabhupada, that he did so much for his disciples because they were doing so much for him.
我们可以从帕布帕德的例子看到，帕布帕德为他的门徒做了那么多，是因为他的门徒为帕布帕德做了那么多。Yeah,
so I would suggest. Yeah, that's another way to think, or an additional way to think about this.
所以我会从另一个角度来给你解释一点，这一点呢不是一个常规的方式，是看待这个问题的另一个视角。And
yes, yeah, you don't want to have a guru that you have to purify yourself from.
你没有拥有guru，你没有拥有guru是因为你还需要净化你自己。You
want to feel purified by his association or her association.
所以你是需要通过他，就是这个guru，他或者那个女旁的他的这个联谊。And
you can see guru like father, like friend, like, you know, very positive things.
你可以把你的guru视为父亲。 朋友或者这样非常积极的东西，这样积极的看待。
Yeah. And you don't have to rush it. It'll happen when it happens.
就是你是不需要紧张的，就是它就是这样发生的，它就发生了。
But as you're looking for a guru, then you also should be thinking, as I'm looking for a qualified guru, I have to look how to become qualified as a disciple.
就是当你去找一位 guru, 你要去找一位 合乎资格的 guru 的时候，你也应该想，我应该成为一个合乎资格的门徒。
Billy Lynn, tomorrow at 10:30, we're having an initiation on Zoom. You should come.
Mao, good day. The first sentence is...
Tomorrow morning in America, we're having initiation.
Oh, 就是明天的早上 Guru Day 他有一个在 Zoom 的这个网络的启迪。
The Zoom address should be on my website.
在那个 Guru 的网站 Facebook website。
My website, not Facebook. Well, both. But I don't know where to find it on Facebook, but on my website, my schedule.
就是明天有一个日程安排，就是关于这个网络的启迪，是在网络上，某个网址上，不一定是 Facebook 上。
We'll talk more about Guru and Disciple tomorrow. So it might be nice for you.
所以明天我们会在那个网络上更多的谈到关于 Guru 和门徒。这个是非常有用的话题，大家都可以来聆听。
We're coming out with an article. We have a newsletter.
就还有一个那个就是时事通讯一篇文章。
And if you go to my website, you can sign up for the newsletter. And the next newsletter is about how the guru chastises the disciple and how the disciple sees the chastisement. I think that would be good for you.
就是那个时事通讯上有一篇文章，就是关于孤儒谴责一位门徒，而门徒是如何来看待谴责的这样一个文章。这会对你们有好处。
May I ask for a link to your website?
Yeah, it's just mahatmadas.com.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. And Facebook, Mahatma Das. And SoundCloud, Mahatma Das. YouTube, Mahatma Das. It's, yeah, everything's there. Okay, we're going to go. We're going to go now.
好，那今天的讲课就到这里。那我们就期待Guru下一次的课程。Okay, thank you, Guru Dev, for your lecture.
Did somebody, posted the link for tomorrow. Is that it, Parker?
Is that the link? PC
yeah,
posted
but I don't
the
know if
link.
It works.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. One more question from Vivian.
Okay.
Vivian ask what is negative energy?
Billy Lynn will have to answer.
I like to say harmful energy because many people have different perspectives of good and evil. I say helpful and harmful, what gets in the way of me focusing on Krishna? So if it's something that causes me distraction, that's harmful.
好了，可以了，可以了，可以了，可以
了。He's have a good life if he has to ask that question.
那都接了两张，结束了，已经结束了。
我们今天的讲课就到这里。大家欢迎大家下周同一时间继续收听。OK, good day.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Lilarani. 我还有一个问题呢，不知道这个问题能不能今天回答呀？因为这个跟今天的主题相关哎。
那你直接问吧，你直接问吧。
Yeah, sorry, Maharaj. I have a question. So may I ask you now?
Okay, I'll give you a short answer.
Yeah. So about the detachment, sometimes we we find the devotee, they may have some misunderstanding about the detachment. So when they practice detachment, they are also maybe they are very indifferent to their family member and also to the people around them. They are not so concerned about them like before. So how can we balance this detachment? We do not go to extreme.
That's not detachment.
就如果是出现那种走入误区或者走极端的话，其实他们这种表现就不是一种这个不依附。
Krishna says a devotee is a friend to everyone. Detachment doesn't mean to be unkind or ignore people.
所以呢，这个不依附并不意味着就对他人不友善或者忽略他人。It's
a misunderstanding.
确实是一种误解。
We had that problem early on in ISKCON. We devotees would be very cold in the name of detachment, but that's not detachment.
对，我们看到在伊斯康早期的时候呢，奉献者会有这种情况出现，就是他们会变得就是对其他人周围的人比较冷漠，然后呢，其实这并不是真正的这种不依附。
Okay. Good. Okay.
Okay. Thank you so much.
You're all invited to the initiation.
It's going to be. 大家参加明天的启迪那个网络启迪。Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. 好。 Thank you. Good day.
It's going to be about.
Thank you. Good day.
12.
Hi, Krishna. Thank you, Maharaj.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Good night.
Good night. Not good. Yeah.
Hare Krishna. See you next time.
See you. Hare
Krishna.
See you tomorrow.
Why not tomorrow? For you it's tonight. Well, for you it'll be 13 hours from now. So it'll be your evening.
Yeah. Okay. 明天是晚上，我们中国时间的晚上了。Okay.
Okay, okay, nice seeing you all. Hare Krishna. Jai Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Hare
Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Aranga Nityananda.
Hare Krishna.